This one guy right here, you can see how he's kind of gray. It's a little hard to get him in focus, but he's a little bit gray and not quite as pink. And he has a little vacuole around the outside. That little white space, that's an artifact of tissue processing. When we soak the tissue doesn't come out of your body pink and purple like this. We have to actually soak it in formaldehyde or formalin, run it through a series of different chemicals to make sure that the tissue doesn't break down. But anyway, back to this little cell here. This little gray cell has this vacuole around the outside, and that's an artifact. And the reason he has that vacuole is because the cell shrinks during processing, and its cytoplasm clumps up to the nucleus. And the vacuole forms around the outside because it doesn't have any desmosomes to hang on to its neighbor. So that's a melanocyte. Melanocytes are not hooked up to their neighbors. In contrast, look at these nuclei over here. These are keratinocyte nuclei, and they actually have that little halo, a little vacuole around their nucleus. Their nucleus is kind of naked, floating in the middle of that little space. That's because when they shrink up, all of their cytoplasm is hooked up to the desmosomes at the outside of the cell, and it can't go anywhere. It's attached to all of the neighbors. So the poor little nucleus shrinks up and is naked and alone. So when you see vacuoles in the epidermis and you're trying to decide, is it a keratinocyte or a melanocyte? If they have the little halo right around the nucleus, it's probably a keratinocyte. If the nucleus has a little blob of spidery cytoplasm around it, like that guy, it's probably a melanocyte. So these two guys here are melanocytes. And normal melanocytes live along the basal layer. Here's another one there. You can kind of tell because you would think melanocytes, their job is what? It's to make melanin, pigment, that makes your skin turn colors. When you tan, your skin gets darker. People that have brown or black skin, darker skin patients, they have more melanin production, not more melanocytes, but their melanocytes are just more active and make more melanin pigment. But you'd say, well, why are the melanocytes gray and not brown? That's because the melanocyte has an unusual job. It makes melanin pigment, and then instead of keeping it and hoarding it all to itself, it actually shares it with all of the keratinocytes around it. So it has these little finger-like processes called dendrites, and it sends these little dendrites out to the keratinocytes that live directly adjacent to it. And the keratinocytes actually kind of eat the little fingers off of those little dendritic branches, and that's how they ingest the pigment into their cytoplasm. So you can actually see this here. It's a little easier in some places. Here we go. If you look at these cells right here, let's see if we can go maybe one higher power, a little closer view. So this is 600 times magnification. So we don't usually use this in real practice, but for a video, this will help. What you can see is that these cells, oh, hold on, I've lost my arrow, there it is. If you can see these cells right here, see how they have a brown pigment in the cytoplasm? That pigment is kind of over top of the nucleus. You can see it up here too. It's kind of like a little umbrella or a cap. And if you look, if you go up this way, that's where the outside world is. That's where the sun is. So the sun would come down and would normally hit these little keratinocyte nuclei. And, you know, sunlight contains ultraviolet rays, and ultraviolet rays damage DNA, and the DNA of cells lives inside the nucleus. And if you damage that DNA, you can get skin cancer and things like that. So the job of melanin is to kind of try to protect your skin, to absorb some of that light and protect your skin from the damaging rays of the sun. So I like to think of it as the melanocyte makes the pigment. See, here's another melanocyte. You know how I know? Look, it's got a vacuole on the outside and then a little blob of gray cytoplasm stuck to the nucleus, okay? So he feeds the melanin to all these keratinocytes around him. I don't know that the cells are actually all boys, but I just like to talk of them like they... Like the cells are people. And if you're a pathologist too long, that's what will happen to you too. So I'm just kidding. Okay, anyway, the pigment up there, that little, it's like a little hat or a little umbrella, I think, to protect the nucleus of the keratinocyte from the sun. So when you see a brown pigmented cell in the epidermis, it's actually probably a keratinocyte, not a melanocyte. You would think that it should be a melanocyte. So, you know, with a little practice, you can do this. That little gray guy there, that's a melanocyte. All these guys up here that are brown, those are keratinocytes. So that clip you just watched is an excerpt from my normal skin histology video, and you can watch the whole thing, the link's in the description down below. But let's see if we can practice now, and if you learned from that, how to tell these things apart. So here we see vacuolated cells in the mid-level of the spinous layer. Are these keratinocytes or are they melanocytes? These are keratinocytes. You can see the nuclei are naked and sitting in the middle of the vacuole. And you can see around the outside of the cell, there's the pink cytoplasm full of keratin filaments. And there are the little spines, the desmosomes that are hooking on the cell to its neighbor. Let's see if we can get higher power to see that for sure. See a really great example. That's perfect. Naked nucleus, cytoplasm on the outside, little spines, little desmosomes, hooking up the keratin filaments and then hooking onto the next cell. All of these clear vacuolated cells you're seeing here are all artifactual vacuolation around keratinocytes. So it's a really useful way. And here, from another area on the same biopsy, again, all of those are keratinocytes. Now let me switch to a different case. So this is an example of an acral-lentiginous melanoma. Acromelanomas often have dramatic pagetoid spread. And look at all of these big, ugly cells. Obviously, the last case I just showed you, the cells were just normal keratinocytes, not atypical cells like here. But these are atypical, really nasty-looking melanocytes, and they're scattering up. All of these cells that you're seeing here are scattering up in this, what we call pagetoid spread. You can watch my video on melanoma, the basics of melanoma. I'll put the link to that down below, too. But look at these cells. They do have vacuoles around them. If I can get it in focus here. They have vacuoles around them, but the space is around the outside, and you can see that there's some kind of pinkish or grayish or sometimes dusty brown cytoplasm sticking to the nucleus. So you can see that the space is around the outside, the artifactual vacuoles around the outside, and the cytoplasm is retained clinging to the nucleus right there. So those are examples, and here's another one up here. See the spaces around the outside? The cytoplasm is hugging the nucleus. And here are more examples here. And then sometimes it gets kind of spidery like that. It's kind of wispy, and let's go to higher power. Wispy and spidery, so it's kind of stretching little arms out to the outside, but it's still sticking to the nucleus. So all of these cells here that you see that have spaces around them, those are all melanocytes. They're melanoma cells in this case. So that's a useful way to tell apart melanocytes from keratinocytes. And remember that Langerhans cells can also do this to some extent. They can have a vacuolar space around them and have a little bit of clingy cytoplasm as well. So telling melanocytes from Langerhans cells can be a little bit more challenging sometimes. But the point is to be able to tell apart the vacuole artifact of keratinocyte from that seen in melanocytes. And with some practice, and you can do this on your own slides and practice, it's actually quite easy most of the time. Thanks for watching. Please like the video if you enjoyed it and subscribe to my channel. Leave any comments or questions in the comment section below. Thanks.